We brought you Holly Montag. Now Stephanie Pratt spills on
the hills.
Plus, Sean Kingston performs. Someone call 911 because this show is burning up. All new Wendy starts now.
Hi, I'm Vivian Pochian from São Paulo, Brazil, and live from the Big Apple, this is the Wendy Williams Show. On today's show, from MTV's The Hills, Stephanie Pratt as Wendy, and a hot performance by Sean Kingston. How you doing?
OMG. Vivian, tell everybody why you're here, what this is, and how we're connected.
All right. This is a personal space protector. That's why I'm here to show everybody. People see me in the street. And what the hell is that? Well, this is something I created to protect me from people who bump me all the time.
She's from São Paulo, Brazil. Yes. And much like the streets here in New York or any city, USA, the streets are very crowded. People do bump into each other.
Yeah,
and
they so step this, on my feet.
Yes.
They cough right on my head.
Yes.
Ah, oh, God. I don't want to get sick, you know? Yeah.
The interesting thing about this is that Stephanie actually wears this on the subway, on the beach, at the clubs. Do we have any here? Look, the pictures are showing. Look at her.
That's on the beach. That's
right.
On the beach. I wear a bikini and this.
Now let's
That's
see what
perfect.
Happens when she
perfect
walks
outfit.
Through crowds in New York on a day when the president is here, the General Assembly is meeting.
Good.
This is now. What is this right here?
Oh, this is my cell phone holder.
Oh, I should have known.
Yeah, it's perfect.
I appreciate you being here. Now, this is your prototype, but you're really trying to, you're very serious about this, huh?
Yeah,
okay.
Sure.
Do you have a boyfriend?
Well, guys can send applications if you want.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm taking applications.
We've got a clip of Stephanie, or Vivian, excuse me. Let's take a look. This is what happens when she walks through the crowd.
Yeah, this is New York City, Brooklyn Bridge. People pretend not to see me, and after
people are parting the seas. People are parting the seas. I love it. Vivian, thank you so much.
You're
I
welcome.
Would kiss you, except I'm too far away. But I'm
tall,
so I can
see.
Mwah.
You see?
It's time for Hot Topics. Is so weird, Vivian. You know, when you're tall, people just get out of your way anyway. When you're big and you're tall, the C's part, and usually it's for something freakish, like, oh my gosh, you know, she's so tall, or the hair, or something like that. But people part the Red C's. It's a busy day here on the show. We do have a Stephanie here, Stephanie Pratt. She's coming through. Sean Kingston is here. And it is an even bigger day for us Melrose fans, because I got the alert on my computer upstairs that Heather Locklear is joining the cast of the new Melrose Place on the CW starting November 17th. I'm really excited. Again, they call our girl in to just really zhuzh things up. The show's doing okay, but how does everything do when Heather touches it? Yeah, exactly. We love it. I want to shout out to my parents' neighbors in Miami, Patty Stanger. You know her from the Millionaire Matchmaker on Bravo. Her mom and dad, Mel and Rhoda, they live in the same building, and they all sit around the pool and stuff. So I just want to give a special shout out to her mom, Rhoda, and you also, Patty. You guys, hang in there. All right. Oh, another mother I want to shout out to. Hillary Duff's mother, Susan, sent me these flowers. Do you remember on Hot Topics just a moment ago, not today, but you know, I was talking about, you know, mothers in Hollywood, and I was saying how Susan Duff does a really good job with Hillary and Haley Duff. And Hillary has just signed on to 7 episodes of Gossip Girl, which we already talked about here on Hot Topics. But she's also starting a clothing line with DKNY jeans called Femme4DKNY. So while the other girls, some of them are out, you know, being crazy and stuff, Susan Duff is really, you know, just helping the girls, and they're really growing into nice young girls. I don't know either one of them, but Susan, this is the time for us to connect and do a little fashion show, because I saw some of the clothes in Hillary's line for DKNY. So let's do a fashion show. Why not? Look, she says to me, I'll give you the inside scoop. So she goes, Wendy, my new best friend, thank you more. She watches the show. She saw me talking about Hollywood moms and saying how, she, you know, I thought she was a really good, you know, manager, stage mom. Anyway, so she says, thank you more than you could ever know for what your kind words meant to me. I will generously pay it forward. Oh, pay it forward. So you come to the show? Oh, anyway, she goes on to say straight from the heart, you know, hoping our paths will cross, Susan Duff. So I appreciate that. That's so nice. I'm hot. Flashing, no doubt. You know, I wish that more mothers would share the experience. Like last night was back to school night at my son's school. And, I talked to a lot of the different mothers in between in the audience and out in the street and stuff. Apparently, this is back to school night week for a lot of the, you know, students and the schools around the country. And it's tough. These kids and the homework and the questions that they ask, and they don't want to hear about our careers or that we're tired or whatnot. So shout out to all the moms. It's, guess what? So there's this book that was actually sitting on my desk this morning from Nancy O'Dell, who's going to be on the show in, what, a few weeks, right, Rob?
Yes.
I can't wait until she gets here. This show got here just in, I mean, this book got here just in time. It's called Mom to Mom Tips, How I Wish Someone Had Told Me When I Was Pregnant. I love that. It's tough. If you happen to be pregnant and about to have your first, hang on. It's going to be a bumpy ride, and all your friends aren't going to share all the secrets. But hopefully, you know, you'll have somebody in your life, you know, to help you out. Oh, you know what? Shout out to all of our viewers in Atlanta. Have you heard about these Atlanta floods? They're like on their 6th or 7th day of raining, and people have actually died. And so the rain is horrible, and we know we've got a lot of you all in Atlanta, so we're really sorry to hear about what's happening, and you all hang in there also. So Kim from Atlanta Housewives, speaking of Atlanta, is being sued. Apparently, yesterday she was forced to remove Tardy for the party. Yeah, after the producer of the show, the song, Don Vito, filed a lawsuit. See, why don't people cover all of this paperwork before they actually come out with something? You know what I mean? Like, why would she just come out and do it on a show that's so watched? Don owns the rights and allegedly hasn't been paid. Hello, Papa! I need a song paid for! Don't you love that? So, Housewife co-star Candy, who's going to be here next week.
Thursday
of this week. Candy's going to be here. Candy Burress. She produced the song and remastered it from the country hit to the pop hit. And she'll be on the show so we can ask her more about that. You know, yeah, on Thursday. I wonder how she's doing. I wonder how they're all doing. Don't we have a pipeline to any of them? Maybe we can call one of them after the show to find out how people are doing in Atlanta. Yeah, all that rain. All right, so, you guys, according to Life and Style Weekly magazine that I love, Khloe Kardashian, who's 25, will marry LA Lakers star Lamar Odom, who's 29, this Sunday. Yes. You guys, don't you love the pictures of them? Look. His hand is on his wallet. You know he's the $33 million man. He just signed a new contract. And if they're going to get married this weekend, so far I've heard no details of a prenup. Hold on to your wallet. And look at Khloe's hand on her bag. Fill her up, please. You guys, seriously, I like their love. You know, it's very fast to happen. They've only been dating for a moment. But, you know, Lamar, first of all, he's been in the NBA for, you know, quite some time. So a responsible man, seemingly. You know, I follow all the hot topics and stuff. I've never heard about anything crazy or screwy going on with him. Late nights, you know, with guns in his pockets and guns going off or bar fights. Or, yeah, you know, he's a clean guy. I like Lamar. Anyway, his previous relationship, he has a baby's mother. They were together for 12 years, and they have two children, a 10-year-old and a 7-year-old. So he never married her, but I've never heard of anything horrible. I mean, marriage isn't for everybody. I've never heard of any horribleness. How do you feel if you're the baby's mom after 12 years and Khloe Kardashian gets the papers? You know, the papers. She said, Well... Look, I'm happy for Khloe and Lamar. And if they get married on Sunday, it's not too late to FedEx an invite this way. I heard it's going to be... I love my Kardashians. I heard it's going to be a small ceremony at a private home. So it won't be so private once the helicopters buzz overhead, though, right? I like it. I like it. $33 million over 4 years. Khloe, hurry up and... get pregnant. Just lock it down. Now look, everyone in America, I know you hear me say that, you know, maybe more times than I should with the young girls. Hurry up, lock them down, get pregnant. I really am for a woman going to college, you know, having a corner office, doing something fabulous, you know, but not everybody can do something like that. And so Kardashians are making a name for themselves. And so I'm not going to hate on Khloe. You know, you wish you could have met a man worth $33 million and not have to work. What? So what are you going to do now, Kim? One day she's the star of the family. The next day she's just one of the girls. And do something quick before Kendall, really, because Kendall, the little sister, that's a firecracker. That's a firecracker. I love you all. Love, love, love all you Kardashians. Oh. Sorry. I went to bed last night at 8:30, right after parent-teacher night, and I had 2 cups of coffee today, so I'm all sorry. Okay, look. So, and today's the first day of fall. Say? I wore a special costume for you. All right, so 50 Cent was allegedly involved in this relationship, this romantic relationship with Ciara. And I say allegedly just to, but I'm telling you, allegedly, this relationship was going on for a moment. And he met her right when she was on the cusp, which wasn't too long ago. Ciara was like hot and popping and doing her thing, and she wasn't quite Beyonce, but no one is, B. But she was working away there. Then something happened, and the CD came out, and you didn't buy it. And Jazzy Faye, who's this record producer that she used to be in business with in Atlanta, you know, anyway, their relationship went sour. And 50 kind of scooped her up and said, come on. And he allegedly got her a Phantom car, and then he allegedly got her that Lamborghini that she speeds around Hollywood with the Kardashians with. It's like 6 degrees of Kardashians on this show, isn't it? She's friends with them Hollywood girls, and he allegedly bought a house and put her up in there. Then she did the video with Justin Timberlake and licked his face. Allegedly, 50 was PO'd. Ciara then got a visit from 50 at his own house, and there was allegedly no food in the refrigerator. Hold on, I'm bringing this all back around to where it's going to make sense, girls. All that means, oh, and allegedly they are no longer together, so there you have that part. But you young girls have got to stop living on dropping it like it's hot and being cute. Men need more than that at the end of the day. If you can't cook, figure out how to gather it, make it work. You know, you could see him coming in the house all, you know, no food, yo. You know, what's that, the video? You're licking his face? Your album flopped and I'm bankrolling your whole situation and you're disrespecting me. Oh, no. Instead of the Kardashians, you should have become friends with Christina Milian, the singer. Yes. Cha-ching. Because she's doing it. I told you guys that Christina and the Dream just got married. No prenup. And he's worth multi-millions and wrote all those fancy songs for all those fancy people like Beyonce. Anyway, Sierra, I'm sorry to hear about what happened. You'll learn next time. Hi, 50. Hi, sir.
How you doing?
How you doing?
What's up, Wendy? I have a couple of comments about your hot topics.
Yeah.
Like, you hear all these young girls in Hollywood. They're going out with these guys. This one went with that one. Sierra's with this one. Chloe's with this one. Kim is with this one. You know, you never really hear about them, like, going to get checked and stuff. Like, you know, before
Would
they...
Would you stop it? Would you stop?
We need to hear that, you know?
What?
They have to get with the real. They have to get what's real.
That,
we need
Chloe
to see.
Chloe was seen coming out of a doctor's office, or Sierra went, people don't get checked at public places. These people have health plans and they go to private doctors. Sir, you're being too technical.
We need to know that. We need to know it. Not about how much your shoes cost, not about your bag. We need to know the real things, like the real.
When's the last time you got your trap checked?
My point exactly.
Thank you,
how
sir.
How you doing?
Okay. So, did you guys see Barack Obama last night, our president, on David Letterman? I didn't see. I went to bed at 8:30. You saw him, though? It was his sixth appearance, but the first as a sitting president on Letterman. And, but the bigger... Ow. I didn't rip them, though. These aren't fishnets. These are from Capizio, you know, the dance store. And so, look, because real fishnets rip, and then you get all slutty, like, you know, you see the girls. Look at these, though. They've got the pads at the bottom. Yes, no, doing it. And they're for the dancers. And if you're a long, tall Sally like me, a lot of times your pantyhose, you know, in yesterday's show, I told you my pantyhose were way down here. These are all the way up. Yes. Okay, look, there's a new book out today, and it's by Christopher Anderson called Barack and Michelle, Portrait of an American Marriage. I can't wait to the weekend, because that's when I'm able to dig into all my books. I just finished Push this past weekend, and I have a book giveaway, as a matter of fact, for you guys later on in the show, but wait, don't, all right, hold on. This book about Barack and Michelle has some really interesting nuggets about the first couple. I have notes here, but I have to tell you, I heard about this book weeks ago. I read all about it in The Inquirer. Okay, where are my nuggets? Okay. Initially, Barack was reluctant to pop the question to Michelle, despite his obvious devotion to her. Until the night of their engagement, Michelle said, look, buddy, take notes, girls. Look, buddy, I'm not one of those girls who just hangs out forever. Shortly after that, he presented her with a 1-carat ring in a velvet box. The book also detailed, take note of the size too, by the way, girls. It's not what you get, it's the potential of what could be in terms of the ring. I know we had an Ask Wendy earlier in the week. The girl was complaining about her ring. But you know, if a woman supports her man and vice versa, in no time at all. So now they're in the White House. All right, more nuggets in the book. The book details craziness surrounding the presidential campaign last year. Political groupies passing phone numbers and the Obama girl. And, you know, he's sexy, and there's some sexy women out there who are very disrespectful of marriage. But Michelle says, according to this book, that she never questioned his fidelity. He's never given me reason to doubt him. The president initially also thought that the Yes We Can slogan was childish and corny until Michelle convinced him otherwise. She said, it'll work. Trust me. Michelle also shot down the notion of Hillary Clinton being vice president, opting for Joe Biden, saying, do you really want Bill and Hillary just down the hall from you at the White House? Could you live with that? Well, they also struggled with fertility issues, and Michelle at one point often accused Barack of being an absentee husband, but now everybody's more focused, and I just love, this book, when does this book come out? Then we have to go to a break?
Today.
Comes out today. All right. We've got another session of Hot Topics. We'll talk about Serena, John Travolta, and more. Keep it here. 300 pounds on her own show. See how she looks now on our show. Plus, she played Moesha's mom, Cheryl Lee Ralph. We to the N to the D to the M. Next, all new Wendy.
The Wendy Williams Show is brought to you by David's Bridal, your complete bridal and social occasion store.
I cannot wait until the weekend. I can't wait to get into this Barack and Michelle book. You know, though, this goes to show that, first of all, they are regular, normal people, and also all of, like I said earlier, the wonderful things that can happen to two individuals when they support one another. I love it. I can't wait until the weekend. Oh, by the way, Kim from Housewives of Atlanta just tweeted in during the commercials, and she says about Tardy for the Party, she's getting her legal issues in order. Did she say anything about the rain?
No.
And tweet back.
How you doing?
All right. Hi, how are you?
I'm doing good. How are you doing?
How are you doing, sir? Yes.
I'd say you're working that dress.
Thank you.
Second, on the Barack and Michelle, well, you know, Michelle used to be Barack's boss when they first started in the law firm.
Yes.
So, I mean, just imagine what kind of game you got to have to come, you know, to get your boss.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah.
I bet you their sex is good.
Oh.
I mean, first family. Everybody has been wondering that. Nobody said a word, but let's talk the obvious, right? I bet you it's good. Yeah. Okay. So Serena Williams is the new spokesperson for Tampax. I love this idea. Procter & Gamble is featuring her in a lighthearted campaign about the Tampax brand. Serena's going to take on the Mother Nature character. The advertising begins in October. And, you know, even with her tirade on the tennis court and her $10,000 fine, Tampax says, that does not affect us. We still want her. And she was a previous pitch woman for Nike and Gatorade. I like the idea that she's their spokesperson because a lot of people wear tampons if they have an active life. And who's more active than, you know, a tennis player? After I had little Kev, I wouldn't put anything in there for ages. It took me, I know that's a lot. I mean, I'm talking about like a tampon. It took me like a while. But now I'm back in the game and I'm a Tampax user myself. How you doing? How are you?
How you doing, Wendy?
Okay.
On the topic about Barack and Michelle's book, you know, it just goes to show you that behind every great man is a great woman.
Yeah.
You know, with Teddy Roosevelt, you know, when Teddy Roosevelt was going through his thing in the past, he had his wife there.
Eleanor.
And it just goes to show you, like, finally there's a woman to go, you know, men are great. And he's a great president. Don't get me wrong. I voted for him and I love
but
him.
But men
But
need...
behind him is that great woman that said, I'm not standing for her unless she's going to give me... what I give you.
Exactly. Thank you. All right. Now, my dearly departed friend, Elin Harris, New York Times best-selling author, you know he passed away at age 54 while promoting this very book. And that this is all recently, about a month ago this happened. Anyway, this Friday will be, the 25th of September will be Elin Harris Day at bookstores all across the country. And everyone in the audience is going to get a copy of this book right here. It's called Mama Dearest. And if you'd love to win your copy, go to my website at wendyshow.com and find out the details. Elin Harris will always mean something to me because, you know, I am a 2-time New York Times best-selling author. When I first became a New York Times best-selling author was with my autobiography in 2002. Elin sent me flowers and he called me privately and he welcomed me into the club and talked to me how, you know, prestigious that is to be a best-selling author. And he was never a hater. And I read this book on our plane trip going to L.A. This is another good one. Shout out to all my readnistas. That's a person who reads. Love you. Okay. Yesterday, the John Travolta extortion trial began in the Bahamas, and I've got some details. This second Hot Topics is running a long time, you guys.
We're over, so speed up.
We're over, so speed up. Okay. Among the potential witnesses at the Bahama trial, which began yesterday, are two people. This is about the two people who were accused of extorting $25 million from the Travoltas. An ambulance driver and a former senator in the Bahamas were allegedly targeting John and his wife, Kelly. You know, their son, Jet, died in the Bahamas, and he was only 16 years old, and they were accused of demanding money in exchange for not publicizing the documents. And his wife, Kelly Preston, and daughter Ella Blue and John were recently seen for the first time since Jet's death at Disney promoting a new movie called Old Dogs, which features Ella Blue. She happens to be in it. So I heard that they're a real nice family. Peace be with you, Walter Voltas. Okay. Which married celebrity couple wants to get their vows renewed already? Find out in the details. One more hot topic coming up next. But next, she's used to major drama every day. We're talking about Stephanie Pratt from The Herald. We'll be back. Watching our first guest as she weaves her way through the good, the bad, and the dramatic on MTV's hit show, The Hills. Take a look at the new season.
Stay away from Liza, Audrina, David.
I think you should come
right here and come talk to me like that.
She's the girl that's going to stab us all in the back, and she doesn't care.
You're with the wrong girl, dude.
These are people's lives that she's messing with. People do have hearts and feelings.
How can one person turn all of our lives upside down?
So what do we do now?
Please welcome Stephanie Pratt. Wow! Oh my God, you're tall.
What?
You are so tall.
Wow.
It's nice to meet you.
It is so nice to meet you.
I love your sparkles.
Thank you. You're like the smiliest person. I love it.
Thank you. Do you watch the show from home, from the hills?
Your show?
Yes.
Yeah, I saw it yesterday. That girl, did she find a third date?
No, you know what? The you're talking about the lady from the Joel McHale show?
No. Your show yesterday.
Opening announce.
Oh yeah, she was looking for the date. The date in 52. Well, she's got about another 15 weeks in the year. She really does watch. So, Stephanie and I have something in common. Joel McHale.
Love for Joel McHale.
If you watch The Soup, as we all should, then you know that Joel, you're like the go-to make fun girl on the show.
Yes, and so I love it.
You apparently have a good sense of humor.
Yes.
I love it also.
It is literally my favorite show.
Yeah.
And it's the only show that I always watch.
Yeah.
And when he started showing clips of your show, and then he was like, everyone must watch Wendy Williams. Do not let the show go off the air.
Yeah.
And then I heard your ratings just like went nuts.
But he helps us all, right?
Oh my God.
Does everybody on your show get the joke? I mean, are they? Okay, yeah.
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 I'm on like a serious drama. I'm the only one who's making jokes that gets edited.
Yeah, so, well, yeah. You know, you're like the tattletale girl on The Hills, everybody on MTV. You guys watch, yes, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Dramatic. So your brother, Spencer, and his wife, Heidi, you're like the go to Spencer about what Heidi's doing. And, you know, you go to other cast members about what the other one's doing.
I'm awful, yeah.
Yeah. Is that you or is that a character?
I mean, we do play ourselves.
Yeah.
But, I mean, for the show to progress,
yes,
everyone needs to know what's going on,
yeah,
since no one's there. Yeah.
Yes, yes, yes. Well, it's really interesting when I found out how you actually became a part of The Hills.
Yeah.
Because originally, you know, Stephanie was working for $300 a week as a hostess at a restaurant.
Yeah.
And tell the rest.
Okay, so I was making $300 a week as a hostess, and I was going to FIDM, and I had just come back from college in Paris to go to FIDM. It's a fashion school. It's always what I've wanted to do. Handbags, love it all.
Yes.
Love your fashion.
Yes, we're going to talk in a moment.
That is not okay. Oh, my God. anyway, so I was making $300 a week being a hostess and going to school. And then I was at FIDM for a year and a half. And one day, Lauren walked into my class.
Conrad.
Lauren Conrad, yes.
Okay. And she had the cameras with her.
Yes.
And The Hills was already on TV.
But here's what had happened is, like, I had already yelled at her and stuff because, like, yeah, at a club, I had yelled at her because,
OMG.
Like, totally, totes.
Dude.
So I had yelled at her and all this stuff. So, oh my God, your cup. Okay.
Thank you. All right, I'll tell the story.
Wait.
No, hold on, this is what happened. No, because I get it. I'm from Ocean Township, and there are a lot of, oh my gosh, and likes there also. So I get how you're talking, and we could go on like this forever.
Dude.
But we got to speed it up, because we're only on for an hour.
Okay.
All right, so look. She and Lauren were fighting. The Hills producers basically said to her, look, you know, you're on the show. And she said, but I don't want to be on the show. I don't want to be famous like this. I'm here to study fashion. I'm just fighting with Lauren. They said, dude, you're already on. Just sign this and we're going to give you $1,000 a week. She says, $1,000 a week? They're like, yeah. And she says, hostess no more. I'm now on the Hills. Got it? Right?
It was the best chance happening ever.
It was the best decision you could have made.
And what was also really great at the time is I had just been fired from being a hostess.
Oh! Because
bones.
What did it take you? It took you 25 minutes to seat somebody. Welcome to the restaurant.
It's been
I'm making jokes with you. By the way, so you're cool with the Brody because he's on the show. Are you cool with the sisters?
No, never cool with Brody.
You're not cool with Brody?
No.
I mean, really?
Yeah,
see,
really.
I'm thinking some of it's acting. Really?
No. Brody, I've known my whole life, and, like, my brother likes to make me cry and stuff. But he stopped, you know? And so, like, Brody's still doing it. And so I was, like, crying on this random day, like, probably last month. And I was like, Spencer, I'm so done. Like, I can't do this anymore. Like, my therapist is telling me to quit. Like, I'm just not emotionally stable. And my brother's like, okay, you know, Stephanie, I'm going to take care of Brody. And I was like, thanks, Spence. And so he was like, I mean, seriously, Brody's like 28. It's like, stop making a 23-year-old little girl cry.
Yeah.
Like, leave me alone.
Yeah, Steph is 23.
Yes.
Do you drive?
Yes. I failed my license test like 3 times, though. Don't, if you see a white X5 with black rims, don't get near me.
What is that, a BMW truck? OMG. But you're making money, though. Okay, here's the thing. Do you get along with your sister-in-law in real life, Heidi?
Okay, well, you're asking me this on a particular day.
Oh.
I wasn't invited to her birthday dinner on Thursday.
OMG.
But in general, yes, I do.
Okay.
And she is the best thing that has happened to my brother.
Oh.
Because my brother has really bad ADHD, which people don't, well, I'm sure people do probably think that. So growing up with him, he was like, I'm a scuba diver, I'm a baseball player, I'm a soccer player. And it was always something, you know?
Yes.
And like, it, like, what was next? You know, always. My parents were just, like, exhausted.
Your dad's a dentist.
Yes,
you guys'
he is.
Dad,
Yes. And,
you know, I know
you're
Holly.
You're due for a checkup.
I'm due for a checkup?
I just want you to come to L.A.
Oh, I'm there, you know.
And visit Joel.
We could do a skit together.
Oh, my God, in the control room.
It was a good one,
It was a really good skit.
Look, did you guys get anything out of this conversation? Other than that, she's 23. She's on The Hills. We love The Hills on MTV. You're adorable and cute, and you're very nice. You know I know Holly.
Holly is the nicest person ever.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so,
what I was saying about Spencer. So basically, he had ADHD, and I have ADD. He has ADHD. He's really all over.
We're out of time.
Your show needs to be longer.
Hello. Check out the all-new drama on the new season of The Hills, premiering September 29th on MTV at 10 o'clock. Ask Wendy is next. Sitting here with that damn personal space hoop. Welcome back. It's time for Ask Wendy. How are you?
I'm good. Hi, Wendy. My name is Atisha, and I have a problem. I've been dating this guy for about a year, and up until recently, I thought he was 23, but I found out via text message he's 19, and I'm 25. You think that's a deal breaker?
Well, there's a big difference between the maturity of a 19-year-old and a 25-year-old. I don't know. What else does he have going on in his life?
I mean, he's a nice guy. He's working. He goes to school. He has a car. I mean, he's doing
he sounds better than a lot of 23-year-olds.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with it.
But he lied for a year.
But that's because he thought that you'd react like this. Give him a hug where his head lands right here. And tell him it's going to be all right.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Take it slow.
We have to.
And don't feed him alcohol.
Exactly.
You know he can't drink. All right. Congratulations. More Ask Wendy next. Stop at the end of the show. Log on to WendyShow.com for must-see moments, free tickets, and upcoming guests. Go to WendyShow.com today. What are you waiting for? Shout it out. Welcome back, everybody. We're still doing Ask Wendy. How are you?
Hey, Wendy. How you doing?
Fine, thanks. How you doing?
Ew.
Ooh. Look, can I just thank you? Thank you, sir. Go
okay,
ahead.
So, Wendy, I've been married 11 years, and my husband thinks I dress too sexy. I have 4 children. You think I dress too sexy with being a mom? What do you think?
Wagawan.
Exactly.
There's nothing wrong with your outfit. How old are you?
33.
And so you got the 4. See, it's my own personal opinion that there are just some men who are stuck in their ways. They want their wives a little downtrodden, whether it's that you don't get yourself together physically or you stay stupid and don't get your education. They think that they're slick for saddling us with a bunch of children, but there's some of us who can clearly still rise to the occasion. I don't know. You know, you're going to have to talk it out with your husband. You knew what he was when you were dating him.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm sorry for you. I'm sorry for you because you're cute and that shouldn't be the way it is.
Okay.
The flies are still here. Sorry. Sean Kingston performs his smash hit. Closed captioning for The Wendy Williams Show is brought to you by Thursday on Wendy. We've had a lot of shows, and you've seen a lot of hairstyles. Now Daisy Fuentes is here, and we're talking hair. Plus, the Real Housewives of Atlanta. We brought you NeNe, Sheree, and Kim. Now it's Candy's turn. All new Wendy. Ooh, juicy. Thursday on Wendy. A Jamaican-raised sensation at only 19. He's the king of the dance floor with his platinum-selling single, Fire Burning. His new CD, Tomorrow, is in stores today. Give it up for Sean Kingston.
Somebody call 911.
Hey!
Shawty, fire burning on the dance floor. Super dang, hot in the sun in the south of Spain. Caught me soon as I walked through the door. My pocket started tickling. The way she dropping low, that thing got me wanna spend my money on her. She get it poppin', lockin', droppin' that birthday cake. Got a candle, need to blow that crazy. Now check my red, black card and my jewelry. Shawty is cold like the fire. She's
one in every 100 years. So ain't no doubt I'm taking it home. Man, I'm a frame of a golden lane. And my game is about to change. She'll be your covers over the world. She get it poppin', I can drop it now. Run around. No exit from the dance floor, so them boys want more. She got that fire in her dance now, make them fellas run around. No exit from the dance floor, so them boys want more. Hands up! Popping like a drop in that birthday cake. Got a candle, need to blow that crazy flame away. Now take my red, black card and my jewelry. Sade is cold like the fire.
Wow, it's so good to see you, honey. You know, he's only 19 years old. I always wanted to ask you this. Is your mom as tall as I am?
Yes.
Yes, very nice. I can't wait till my little Kevin gets to be big and strong like this. Who's the special lady in your life, Sean Kingston?
You.
Oh.
And all the rest of the ladies in the crowd right here, for real.
Smart answer. Pick up Sean's new CD tomorrow, available online and in stores today. One more Hot Topic next. Time for one more Hot Topic. Earlier in the show, I asked you which married couple is ready to renew their vows already. Eva Longoria and Tony Parker. They were just married 2 years ago. The wedding cost $1 billion. But the time goes by so fast, so they say it's time to renew. Small and intimate this time around. Okay, on tomorrow's show, Ruby Gettinger and friend to the show, Cheryl Lee Ralph. I love you for watching. See you next time on Wednesday.